Did you know that a headwind hurts more than a tailwind helps? In fact, at higher wind speeds, a headwind will hurt more than twice as much as a tailwind helps. When you hit into a headwind, your shots carry shorter, fly higher, and land steeper. But why is that? This is due to lift and drag. Lift is what makes the ball rise, and drag is what slows the ball down. Under calm conditions, the air is moving into the golf ball at the speed the ball is traveling. When there is a tailwind, the wind speed subtracts from the airflow. On the other hand, a headwind adds to the airflow. The faster the airflow, the greater the amount of lift and drag. And that is why you see the ball balloon when hitting into the wind. It's a common misconception that a ball spins more when hit into a headwind. Actually, it's the extra lift created by the added airflow that gives this impression. Nonetheless, more spin also creates more lift and drag. Into a headwind, spin is the enemy. Trying to swing harder is not the answer. Swinging harder likely creates more club speed, which creates more spin, and that will not get you where you want to go. Instead, use a club with less loft. This will help you optimize for the conditions and hit the ball the correct distance, reduce the spin loft, and therefore reduce the spin rate. On the other hand, a shot with too little spin in a tailwind will turn that ballooning shot into one falling to the ground. That's because lift also keeps the ball in the air. A tailwind will produce shots that carry longer, fly lower, and land flatter. And although you can use a higher lofted club to create more spin, the best bet is to launch the ball higher so that it will land steeper and stop quicker. The complicated piece is that lift and drag do not behave linearly to airflow. And that is why a headwind hurts more than a tailwind helps.